divine grace is the time of the call. Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacrament. You were sent to heal the contrary of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father, intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your Spirit, O Lord, we pray, imbue us powerfully with spiritual gifts, that he may give us a mind pleasing to you, and graciously conform us to your will. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Wishing to determine the truth about why Paul was being accused by the Jews, the commander freed him and ordered the chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin to convene. Then he brought Paul down and made him stand before them. Paul was aware that some were Sadducees and some were Pharisees. So he called out before the Sanhedrin, "My brothers, I am a Pharisee, the son of Pharisees. I am on trial for hope and the resurrection of the dead." When he said this, a dispute broke out between the Pharisees and Sadducees, and the group became divided. For the Sadducees say there is no resurrection, or angels, or spirits, while the Pharisees acknowledge all three. A great uproar occurred, and some scribes belonging to the Pharisee party stood up and sharply argued, "We find nothing wrong with this man. Suppose a spirit or an angel had spoken with him." The dispute was so serious that the commander, afraid that Paul would be torn to pieces by them, ordered his troops to go down and rescue Paul from their midst and take him into the compound. The following night, the Lord stood by him and said, "Take courage, for just as you have borne witness to my cause in Jerusalem, so you must also bear witness in Rome." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep me safe, O God, in your heart. Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord, are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night, my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. You will show me the path to life. Fullness of joy is in your presence. The delights at your right hand. The world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one, as we are one. I in them, and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know where they were sent, and that you love them even as you loved me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known, that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In general, when we speak about the Lord's words to those who are listening to him, we generalize and say that he was speaking to us as well, but we know that literally he was only speaking to the people who were listening, but we can feel confident in extending that to us as well. But today in the Gospel, we actually hear the Lord speaking explicitly about us, those who have come to believe in him through the words and the preaching of the apostles. And he says, in fact, that we are the Father's gift to him. And this is an extraordinary way of thinking, that we have been given to the Lord as a gift by the Father. How remarkable. How much it gives us meaning as disciples of the Lord, that he not only loves us and gave up his life for us, but sees us as a gift. No matter who we are, what our status is, what our sins may be, we are still the gift of the Father to the Lord Jesus. This is a concept that's worth praying with, especially in these days of the novena between the Ascension and Pentecost, when we prepare to receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. To think of ourselves as gift and all that we have as gifts, it's a beautiful way to practice gratitude, and that, of course, is a great hallmark of the love of God, when we think and feel and respond in ways of gratitude for all the gifts that God has given us. Today's special gift in the sequence of the novena between the Ascension and Pentecost is counsel. Counsel, which is kind of a supernatural prudence, when we take the knowledge that we have of the commandments of the Lord and the understanding that we have of his ways and apply them to the particular situations in our lives. This is when we receive the counsel, the advice, in a sense, from the Holy Spirit about how to live and how we ought to act and speak in every particular instance. No matter what we go through, gratitude is always something that we should do under the counsel of the Holy Spirit. Because even in times of great suffering, even in times of pain, we always have things to be thankful for. If nothing else, then the Lord has created us, the Lord has loved us, the Lord has given us the promise of redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ. May we continue to dwell on this throughout these days, confident in the love of the Lord, and in the gift that we truly are to the Lord from the Father. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the Lord Jesus, King of glory, conqueror of death and sin, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder, the mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowest, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, come and pass with joy, every land and people exalt in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the ending hymn of your glory as they enter. Holy,
holy, holy, holy, Lord, God of hosts.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples. Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation be grateful, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm and faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have given you your room. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family and their son before you. In your compassion and merciful heart, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all the world.
through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, he prepares. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Gracious Spirit, and peace in our days. But by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await your blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Lord is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, and peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity, in accordance with your word, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, tell you the truth.